Thank you so much. Before I start, I'd like to have a nice round of applause for Cindy and all the teachers at the Stewart School of Music, as well as the students. One of the things that I'm very, very, very devout about in all of the travels that I do for performance is music education. It is so valuable for all the kids that she had mentioned that performed on the first recital here that have gone on to careers in law and in medicine, and as well as for those that go on and maintain being musicians. They always will have an appreciation for it. And so I'm very thankful for all the education I've gotten in music. Now, ironically, I've done all of my degree work on the trumpet. And I am obviously not holding a trumpet right now. Well, a very funny looking trumpet, I guess. That. This is an instrument, the accordion, that's pretty maligned through the culture in the United States. I learned initially from my father and my mother. My mother was actually my first music teacher. And my father was a professional accordionist as well. But I actually only took two formal lessons on this instrument my entire lifetime. And the gentleman that I studied those two lessons with was a gentleman by the name of Don Lipovac in Kansas City, who was probably one of the most influential mentors in my life. He passed away about 6 weeks ago, and so I'd like to dedicate this little arrangement of some Eastern European folk songs to his memory.
Thank you.
one other instrument here. That is commonly, that instrument there is called a piano accordion.
Can you use the mic, please?
Sorry, sir.
Is this better?
Yeah.
I feel like the guy. I feel like the wizard in the Wizard of Oz. Yes. But anyway, that was the piano accordion, or as is affectionately referred to as the belly bulb or the stomach Steinway, because it has the obviously the piano keyboard on one side and a row of buttons on the other. For all of the musicians in the room, I'll save the music theory discussion on why it's all arranged the way it is for another time. But I'm going to play the second piece that I have on my program here on an instrument that is called a button accordion, or called a button box. It is thus named a button box because it is a box of buttons.
Sure.
Forms of this instrument are found in the Irish cultures and in Mexico, but this one here is probably the grandfather of all of those. It comes from Austria, and this version is a diatonic heligon, is its actual musical name. Diatonic because it only plays in certain keys. This one plays in the keys of G, C, F, and B flat. It does not play all the notes of a chromatic scale. Now, the left hand is thus called a heligon because you leave the left hand of this instrument itself, which is the ancestral name of a tuba. And then I put them all together, and I should probably play a traditional Austrian folk song or something of the ilk. But I won't. I love doing that, it's all good, but I'm going to do a little arrangement that I recorded on an album a few years ago, and as Cindy had mentioned, when I was a junior in high school, I had the opportunity through the Florida All-State program to perform in the London Symphony Orchestra. I did a two-week performance study. Every 2 years, they would do a residency in Daytona for the Florida International Festival. And so I had the opportunity to study with the members of the brass section of the LSO and got to perform this next selection in a concert conducted by John Georgiadis. Now, it is a hoedown from Aaron Copland's Rodeo.
Oh, nice.
And I always thought a hoedown really doesn't quite work with a symphony orchestra. So it'll sound a lot better on a button accordion. And so this is my arrangement of Aaron Copland's Hoedown mixed up with a little fiddle tune you might recognize called the Orange Blossom Special.
Oh, cool. That's good.
Hi, Brody.
Thank you.